You're watching the special episode of Young Turks on CNBC TV 18. And now I'm going to throw the spotlight on two of the seven companies that Rana Daggubati and Prasad Vanga of Anthill Studios are betting big on. My first guest on this segment is Comic Flix, which is a technology platform that converts movies and videos to stunning graphics novels. Okay, so if I can ask you, what was the brainchild behind this idea?
So Olivia, my founder, she is the one who started this company. Inspiration was to make kids to read. Mm-hmm. So she envisioned like a read button next to the play on Netflix. That's why the Comic Flix name arose.
Fantastic. So Olivia, what is the appetite for graphic novels in India? And how do you see that market growing, really?
So this is not just about graphic novels. I see this as about loving movies. So everybody that loves movies mm-hmm. would love to consume this in a different format. Mm-hmm. And this is about, you know, we think that the future is in building automation mm-hmm. where lots of wonderful stories that have been told via movies can be converted in this readable format. And if you think about it, there's lots of movies that are sitting on the shelves, mm. that big titles that we like, but there are no ways for content owners to monetize them or fans to re-engage with them.
Absolutely.
So this format lends itself very well for fans to re-engage, for content owners to find that new way of monetizing, you know, finding a new monetization.
If I can ask you, what's the kind of technology that you're using to actually do this conversion, and how long have you been in business at Comic Flix?
Essentially, it's a large-scale image and video processing platform with lots of machine learning and fast-scale GPU servers that do this processing. And then we have a comic editor to finish off all the work. And we landed our first customer here, and movies is where we are applying this technology to.
And if I can ask you who your target audience is going to be?
So my target audience is primarily the teenage young audience, let's say from 12 to 25, that's going to be the major audience. But since we are multilingual, so almost every language we want all good content to be translated into. So that's where we are focusing on for the next decade or so.
It's time to throw the spotlight onto the final guest on this special edition of Young Turks. And Sai is the youngest entrepreneur that Prasad and Rana are betting big on. Sai, thanks for speaking to us here on CNBC TV 18. And tell us about your company, Scapic, and what exactly do you do, and why do you seem to have appealed to the two investors?
At Scapic, a team of talented folks and I primarily work on trying to make virtual and augmented reality incredibly simple mm-hmm. for brands, businesses, and enterprises to get up and running. Today, VR and AR, even though they are buzzwords and perhaps the next big thing in the industry,
absolutely.
It's exceptionally difficult to get up and running mm-hmm. in terms of content creation. It takes too long, costs too much. Mm-hmm. We don't know the right tools, and it's a very inefficient process. So Scapic is building the WordPress for virtual and augmented reality, which mm-hmm. makes it incredibly simple for others to get up and running.
Now, if you look at the industry and the growth of the industry, especially when it comes to VR and AR in entertainment in India versus the rest of the world, do you think we are laggards? And do you think a company like yours, like Scapic, could actually help change that?
Deep technology product companies in the Indian space have always been a challenge, mm-hmm. but I do think the environment and the ecosystem have become incredibly conducive for the same mm. over the recent past. Mm. There has been a sharp shift in the ability to build, think, and execute on some of these future-facing technologies.
Sure.
So even though there does exist perhaps a canyon that we can, of course, match up to from a San Francisco versus India perspective, mm. I do believe that we are closer than ever in sure. terms of being competitive as well as complementary to the global technology landscape. And in that process, it is fascinating to see a new breed of startups which have the ability to build and execute on tough technology challenges for industries that require these solutions.
Well, Sai, if I can ask you to look into the future, and what exactly do you say your target 2025 is for Scapic, and how will partnering with Anthill Studios, how will their funding help you in achieving this target?
We see the way consumers interact with devices to go more into virtual and augmented reality over between where we are to the next few years as such. It's almost going to be as big as, say, what smartphones did to the way we use devices. So when that moment hits in, the inevitable question becomes, how do we consume media and entertainment? And that opens up an entire new set of verticals and the way we can add value to these verticals. And it's really once a leg into the future and one into technology is really where we find ourselves in. And some of these journeys are best catalyzed by the industry experts, right? The ones who've been there over decades together. And that really is where we find this a catalysis as compared to anything else, to bring a solution faster, more efficient, and at a bigger scale.
That was Comic Flix and Scapex, just two of the seven entrepreneurs that Prasad and Rana at Anthill Studios are betting big on. But like we saw over the last couple of minutes, really, the media and entertainment industry has undergone a paradigm shift from the days of black and white cinema to now digital platforms for any kind of media and entertainment, and watching it on your smartphone, really. And that is exactly what Anthill Studios are hoping to bet big on in the next couple of years, the disruptors of technology and the role that they can play in the entertainment space. With that, it's an absolute wrap on this special edition of Young Turks on CNBC TV 18. Thanks for watching.